Hello dear friends, this is Dr. Dipesh Patel and I'll be teaching you Air Propulsion and Aircraft Engineering. This is lecture 5 of Principles of Air Propulsion, and today in this lecture I'm going to be cover ramjet engine and pulsejet engine. So let's begin with the ramjet engine. As you can see the diagram of ramjet engine, it does not have any compressor or a turbine that we have seen in turbojet engine. So ramjet engine is a air breathing and a steady combustion or continuous flow engine. It was invented by a French engineer Rene Lorin in 1913. It was also called ethoid larynx tube or flying stovepipe. Now let's go through the constructions and working of ramjet engine. Ramjet engine is the simplest of all the air breathing engines, and it consists of only supersonic and subsonic diffusers, a combustion chamber with fuel injector and a discharge nozzle, as you can see in diagram. So it does not have any rotating parts. It does not have any reciprocating parts as well. So it is one of the simplest air breathing engine. Now let's see how does that work. First of all, let's consider the atmospheric air which is coming from the atmosphere and enter into the engine. So air enters the diffuser at a very high velocity and it gets compressed, so the velocity will be converted into the pressure. Air is compressed in two stages by the diffuser, since usually ramjet operates at supersonic speed. So the first stage of compression takes place in converging section of diffuser, then second stage of compression takes place in diverging section of diffuser. In diffuser, the kinetic energy of air entering in converted into the static pressure, which is called ram pressure. The air then enters the combustion chamber, fuel is injected, where it is ignited by means of spark plug. The hot combustion gases then expand in the exhaust nozzle with a velocity exceeding a velocity of air coming, and thus due to change of momentum of working fluid, reaction produce to the ramjet structure through pressure at of diffuser and shear forces all over the surface of the engine, and thus thrust is developed in the direction of flight. Now let's understand how does the working cycle for the ramjet engine. The ramjet engine works on a Brayton cycle. An ideal cycle process is shown as 1-2, 2-3, 3-4 and 4-1. So for ideal cycle, 1-2 is isentropic ram compression, then 2-3 is a heat addition, it's a constant pressure heat additions, then 3-4 is isentropic expansion in nozzles. But in actual practice there will be a losses due to shock, friction and mixing at the diffuser, and losses in the nozzle too. So the actual compression and expansion takes place by the process 1-2 and 3-4 respectively, which is shown in the diagram. Now what is the performance of ramjet engine? At lower speed the fuel consumption in ramjet is very high. At high speed it reduces considerably. This is because at low speed the compression is poor, because the air is coming into the engine is because of the speed of the engine. So when there is a low speed, the overall rate of air which is entering into the engine is lower, and therefore the compression is poor. The ramjet engine cannot operate under the static condition, as there will be no pressure rise in the diffuser, and it is not self-operating at zero flight velocity. Since the cycle pressure ratio of ramjet engine depends on its flight velocity, higher flight velocity, larger the ram pressure, and consequently larger the thrust. And therefore, ramjet engine need a launching device. Ramjet is boosted up to a speed of 290 km per hour by a suitable means such as turbojet engine, different kind of the turbojet engine, before the ramjet produce any thrust, and must be boosted to even higher speeds before the thrust produce exceed the drag. It is most efficient at high velocity of about 1700 to 2200 km per hour and at very high altitude. The ramjet engine is widely used in high-speed aircrafts and missiles due to its high thrust at high operational speeds. So it is widely popular in missiles because it can fly at very high speed. Now let's go through the advantages of ramjet engine. The first advantage, that it is used for extremely high speeds. The second advantage, that it is very simple in construction since it does not have any moving parts, it does not have any rotating parts such as compressors or the turbine. Third advantage, that it is considerably inexpensive as compared to the turbojet engine, and it required no maintenance. Fourth advantage is that it can be operated with the any type of liquid fuel, so it does not require any special fuel at all to operate the engine. Let's go through the disadvantages of the ramjet engine. Ramjet engine can only be used in extremely high speed applications such as fighter planes or the missiles. Second disadvantage, which is a major disadvantage of ramjet engine, is it cannot be started on its own. It required a launching device, and once it reached the special speed, it can be launched. Third disadvantage, due to high speed, the combustion chamber required a flame holder to stabilize the combustion. Because it is operating at high speed, we required some kind of device to hold the flame inside the combustion chamber. So these are the disadvantages of the ramjet engine. Now next one is a pulse jet engine. Now pulse jet engine is also a similar as a ramjet engine, since it does not have any compressor or turbine, and it can be operated at high speed too. I mean, it has a limitations that it cannot be operated at the low speed. So these are the characteristics which are pretty much similar to the ramjet engine, though it has a certain differences. And pulse jet was invented during the World War II by the Germans for their flying bombs. And this is a kind of picture which has been taken during the World War II. And here you can see the pulse jet engine was used as a flying bomb. Now, a pulse jet engine is a very simple form of IC engine based jet engine in which the combustion occurs in pulses. The pulse jet engine is free from moving parts such as compressor, turbine, or any propeller. And it is little similar to ramjet engine, but pulse jet engine use an intermittent combustion process, while ramjet use a continuous combustion process. The pulse jet engine develops the thrust by high velocity of jet of exhaust gases. It is consist of, you can see in the diagram, it consists of the diffuser. The special equipment that it use here is a reed valve, combustion chamber, and exhaust nozzles. This diagram describes the different stages of the combustion process. As you can see, the fresh air gets entered into the engines. When the reed valve opens, then fuels are injected, and the mixture of air and fuels are ignited with the help of spark plug, and then These gases, these combustible gases, gets out from the engine through the nozzles, where the high pressure gases are converted into the high velocity, and this jet, this come out in the form of jet, which produce the thrust. So the special equipment that it has is a reed valve. Now reed valve is allow the fresh air at an intermittent stages. So the reed valve is passes the air through the passages, and it opens and close simultaneously. So when there is a pressure difference between the diffuser and the combustion chamber, if the pressure of the diffuser is higher, then it allows the fresh air to enter into the combustion chamber. Then it, since the air gets entered into the combustion chamber, the mixture is ignited and the pressure of the combustion chamber rises. At that time, the reed valve do not allow any more fresh air, and then these gases, combustible gases, is get out from the nozzles. And if these gases go out from the nozzles, the pressure of the combustion chamber reduces, and as compared to the diffuser, and then the next cycle begin. Now fuel in the form of gas or liquid aerosol is injected into the combustion chamber. So here fuels can be used in the form of gas or liquid aerosol. Now this combustion is initiated by the spark plug, as we have seen in IC engine. So here, since we know that the combustion takes place in intermittent process in various stages, so we need to required a spark plug to ignite the mixture when there is a requirement. As combustion takes place, the temperature and pressure of the combustion gases become higher as compared to the room pressure, and hence the reed valve gets closed, and these high pressure hot gases exit through the exhaust nozzles, and the high kinetic energy is generated since the area of the nozzles is gradually reducing, and that produces the forward thrust. Now due to escape, since we know that the gases has been escaped from the combustion chamber, due to escape of gases to the atmosphere, the pressure reduces inside the combustion chamber, and therefore the ram air forces the reed valve to open and fresh air enter into the combustion chamber for the next cycle. So pulse jet engine is highly suitable for bombers and target missiles, as it is useful for the short flights. It produces very high noise and severe vibrations due to intermittent pulse. So these are the few drawback of the pulse jet engines. Now let's go through the couple of important advantages and disadvantages of the pulse jet engine. The first advantage, that it is relatively inexpensive. If you compare with the jet engine, it is relatively inexpensive. Second one, it's simple in construction, since it does not have any rotating parts. So it has a simple constructions. Third, that it does not require any launching device. Unlike the ramjet engine, it does not require any launching device. It can be self-operated. Though it has a one disadvantage, that it doesn't have the ability to produce thrust at low speed. So it need to be operate at very high speed. All right, that's it for the now. If you have any confusion, you can write down in the comment box. Thank you very much.